I guess I could add some of my joint, but they might not answer, especially if it's a kid. Unless we grab the mics from the pod. Them shits are kind of heavy though. But hey.
Uncle Tuna.
What's your backpack?
My brand is called Made in Bodega. Made in Bodega. We're located in New York, 554 East 141st Street, Bronx, New York.
You guys said you guys got here yesterday. What made you come straight to LA right away?
Actually, we were planning on coming to LA no time soon, but I got a 16-year-old son. He came here with his friend. He snuck here. So I was like, all right, I'm going to come over there and fuck with him too. So I was like, since I'm going to do that, might as well bring some clothes with me.
How's the experience been so far?
It's cool, you know. I like the LA vibe. They definitely got good weather. Got some pretty women and yeah, some good food. Can't complain. Triple threat.
Prettier women here or in New York?
That's like comparing Biggie and Tupac. They got some bad joints here. But it's a little different. It ain't nothing like a New York joint either.
Yeah, it's
different.
What about the fashion?
I feel like New York is fashion. I feel like we make it and everybody else take it or try to replace it or try to mimic it. No shade to Cali, but everybody comes to Cali for weed and they come to New York to get fly. Y'all got the weed,
yeah.
But we got the fashion. Y'all got the weed. Guns too. But
anything else you want to shout out your brand or anything?
Yeah, man, just shout Made a Bodega. Made a Bodega runs the world. I'm 4 years in, and I'm gonna take it to the top. I'm opening another Made a Bodega in Houston, Texas, in November. 90% of my stuff is one of one, and I felt like I don't want to compete with anyone that makes clothes because we don't make clothes. We make art.
Yeah. All right, what was your name?
Derek.
Derek, okay, so we got Derek. Seen him skating, he looked pretty cool. Wanted to ask you, what is your style? Like, how does it compare to what you usually see?
Well, it depends where you are. Right. I feel like when I'm out here, I see more of what I'm wearing a lot. But when I'm in Fontana, I don't see this as much.
Yeah.
But I feel like here, I fit in because maybe I'm still doing something different, but I feel like, I mean, just look around, everyone's kind of got on baggy stuff.
Yeah,
it's kind of the vibe, and I'm skating, so it's like I gotta be in some shit with my balls. I kind of cut it down perfect, but I don't know if I can see that.
And then you said you're over at the hundreds. Do you ever see people like impress you like with their style? Or, like,
every day.
Because I know there's a lot of people now too that like they kind of shit on like LA style, especially like people from New York.
I think anybody shitting on any kind of style from anybody else is just saying that they probably ain't comfortable with their own style enough to feel fly all the time.
Yeah,
that's probably the only difference. But like, I get game from literally everybody on the street. Like I saw y'all walk by already.
Yeah.
But I get game from everybody on the street. Like it could be the 12-year-old. Like these are from like this 18-year-old girl who comes into the store and she skates. She works at PacSun, but she had those Osiris on. I'm like, damn, you're like swagging those out.
Yeah.
Gave me the confidence to get them. She's 17. She doesn't care about me. Yeah. But it's like I'll dig in anybody's bag because that's all this is.
it's not that like serious to be mad about it.
No. Anytime somebody's digging in my bag, I'm like, damn, I must have did something that was halfway decent.
Yeah.
So I'm like, all right.
And then last thing, we want to give you a chance to win $100 off in the store, but you got to finish the lyrics. If you get it right, you get $100 off. Might get a little vintage skateboarding tee, you know?
Okay.
Vintage Stussy.
Okay.
Single stitch.
Anything free, I'm in. So. Okay.
We got some Dunks too, and some other skating shoes.
Okay, I'm getting aroused.
Pause. But it's quick, you might know it. She get it, hopefully, Dominic definitely knows about it already. Put him in smoke, he. Nope. One more time.
Put him in smoke.
Put him in smoke, he.
I listen to old shit. Now I'm interested.
That was, what song was it? Oh, that's Hood by Air. Did you hear that?
See? No.
Yeah.
No.
By Cardi.
See, I don't listen to Cardi.
Yeah.
Or Ken Carson.
Yeah, we were saying, like, probably no one's going to get it today.
But that's good, though.
Yeah.
Because I'm going to go. Eventually, you'll see me on the street, maybe in a month, maybe in 2 months, maybe a week. But I'll be having some t-shirts with Porsches on them.
Yeah.
And if you can name what year it is, you can keep the shirt. And if not, fuck off. Not really fuck off.
Study on my Porsches.
Hey. But... get your studying up, because it's a nice little t-shirt, got all the sizes, and you guys maybe, because you get three guesses, so I mean, technically.
1970, 1971, that's just all my three guesses. But, thank you, man.
No, thank you, guys.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. I'll come by the store.
Dom with like a 4 hour sleep. Where's my water? Huh?
Can you interview? Can I interview?
Me?
You wanna be in an interview?
Sure.
So we have a vintage store over there down the street.
Oh, for real?
And so we're just shooting content for it right now.
Oh yeah, sure.
And we don't want you to wait for us, so we're gonna do it right now, right here.
Oh okay, yeah, bet. Good.
So what piece did you get right there?
I didn't get anything today, actually.
No, but what are you looking
right
at?
Here, the Howleys. There, this looks sick. Kind of low key vibe.
Okay. And then, how would you describe like your personal style? We see you got the vintage NASCAR tee.
Oh yeah,
you got the pleasures.
I love thrifting, man. Just like, I think more like rugged, kind of. I like silver jewelries, chrome, everything. Yeah.
What's a trend that you're ready to see go away?
Skinny jeans.
Because they're saying they're making comebacks. Skinny jeans.
Really? I mean, it will work if you're like wearing like some tailored stuff, then it will work. Or like something like with ladders, I think it will work.
And but, if you give one piece of fashion advice to someone, what would you say?
Don't follow anyone else. Just like do what you like. Like wear what you like, and go thrift and like you know get some deals.
I'm about to become myself now. Thank you. What's your name?
Evan.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you, bro.
I don't even know.
I have. There's nothing bad.
Oh, yeah.
If you could do it all over again, what would you change?
If I could do it all over again, what would change? Okay. I would definitely spend more time with my loved ones because you never know when they're gonna pass and you're gonna regret it for the rest of your life. So cherish every moment and live your day like it's your last. Amen.
Yes. Amen. Alright, so I'll just ask you, so what's your name?
JB.
JB. And how would you describe your fashion?
How do I describe my fashion? I don't know. I really don't know how to describe it. Just like, go with the flow.
So it's just stuff that you see that you like?
Yeah, however I'm feeling.
Do you ever get like a little bit of inspiration from maybe certain people or like certain people seeing the show?
Homeless people?
Or what? Homeless people.
It's like the shorts, the jean shorts over the jeans.
Yeah.
That type of shit. What else? I don't know, like the layers, how they layer their clothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty much where it gets on.
And then you see anything that you don't.
Mass fashion. I wouldn't say like skinny jeans because like we used to rock skinny jeans back in the jerking days.
Apparently they're making a comeback.
Yeah.
I just don't like when people wear their tags, like the purple jeans, and like, it's sick.
So they'll never catch you wearing red some Amiris or something.
I mean, yeah.
That's Dom's trick.
Really?
He knew that.
Oh, he's cooked.
He's cooked?
He's cooked.
He's cooked. JP said. If you could give, like, one last piece of advice.
I wouldn't be bland and say just be yourself, because a lot of people say that, but I'd say honestly just, I mean, listen to music, be creative, be passionate about what you put on, don't think too hard at the same time, it's a lot of work. Just live it.
And then we want to give you a chance to win $100 off at the store. I know you like to shop there, so this could be pretty useful. You gotta finish some lyrics. But I have a good feeling about you, because some other people, they didn't really know it, but we'll see. Ready? Put him in smoke. He.
Wait.
Huh? Put him in smoke. He.
Cooked.
Damn.
I'm cooked. What was it? What was it from?
I think it's smoke.
What's that from? What song?
Go by it.
Yeah.
You haven't listened to that?
No.
Damn. I would have expected people to have listened to it. Yeah. We're also saying people might not get it at the same time. So.
Okay.
Thank you for trying.
No problem. I appreciate you.
Some crazy good advice. What's the advice, bro?
Listen, when you buy shoes for someone, they say it's a bad luck to buy someone shoes, because if you buy them the shoes, it means you want them to walk away from your life. So they gotta give you something, or they gotta purchase it from you. At least $1, $5, $10. Over sticker.
Yeah.
Make money.
Thank you. That a lot, bro.
Yeah,
thank
bro.
You. Well, thank you guys.
Brian Crane,
aka
Country Boy,
aka
the big man on campus, King of Melrose.
So we wanted to ask you a couple questions. First being, how would you describe your own personal style?
I describe my style as punk in its core.
Where do you think that derives from?
Just a misfit nature, bro. Growing up, liking skateboarding, Dragon Ball Z,
yeah,
fucking being outside riding bikes and shit.
Yeah.
Just street kid shit, bro.
And then, compared to like what the style that you have now, is there anything that you see, like, obviously being at the flea market all the time and seeing different types of people in LA? Is there anything you don't like?
What I don't like?
Any trends you want to end?
Something I would like to end. Sorry, I'm not race baiting. This is not a racist comment. I would like for all the white women to stop wearing dirty Air Force Ones. White ones. White shoes.
The cooked ones.
Bro, please. Please just please. I love y'all. But please, no more white Air Forces. Dirty ones with the creases.
If they're clean, it's
if you're clean, you're good, bro. Like, they be having the stomper, the beaters out. You feel me?
You gotta keep them clean.
When we gain the Cranes Nike collab.
Cranes Nike collab actually coming later this year. They don't know it yet, but it's happening soon.
And then if you give like a piece of advice to anyone in fashion or trying to get into clothing, or trying to just look better in general.
Yeah. Just saying. Bro, if you're feeling something or you got a vibe, just do it. On some Nike shit, just do it. Don't give a fuck what anyone says, bro. Just do that shit.
Thank you, Cranes.
Yes, sir. Thank you, my dog.
Amazing wisdom.
Yes, sir.
As always.
Yes, sir.
Adios.
If you could do it all over again, what would you have changed? One thing that you wish you knew when you were younger.
Yeah. I let my designs, my all the stuff that I'm doing right now, I got off for a few years to work for somebody else, and I should have did that, but I did it.
Yeah.
So that's the only thing that I changed. I would not go work for nobody else, just for impressing.
Yeah.
That was beautiful. Really makes you think.